Today we had our rock cycle activity where you got a chance to experience parts of the rock cycle, and I just wanted to go over some of the student created maps that we saw today. And while I'm talking about them, I just want you to keep in mind the rock cycle itself isn't a particle going through the entire cycle before it gets back to where you know it began or whatever, or where you started seeing it. It can get stuck in the mini side cycles, and that could take millions of years for a particle to break out of that side cycle. It's the igneous cycle, the sedimentary cycle, and the metamorphic cycle. They all together make up the rock cycle. So I went ahead and I took some pictures of different maps that people had. And as I was going around, I was asking you, did you think that everyone took the same path as you went around? And I was prompting you a little bit about asking you questions about the probability of each of the die rolls. Okay, so does your map look exactly like this? No, it doesn't, okay? So the idea here is this person got stuck in the subcycle down here, which was the igneous subcycle, okay? And that's okay. One of the things I'm trying to get you to see from this activity is that the rock cycle as a whole is broken into three subcycles: the igneous subcycle, metamorphic subcycle, and sedimentary subcycle, all right? A particle or mineral could get stuck in those subcycles for a really long time. Okay, so if we counted, you know, they went in at 11 and ended at 20, so that was 9 rolls. So they were stuck there for 900,000 years. All right, does that make sense? Okay. Now this person had a totally different experience. They didn't even get down to the igneous or metamorphic subcycle. They spent their whole time up here in the sedimentary subcycle up here. They spent actually, you know, pretty much they spent almost 2 million years there. So 1,800,000 years.
Bless you.
1,800,000 years, because they did 18 rolls in there, okay? Sediments can get stuck in these cycles virtually forever, okay? And then this person, this map was a more rounded map where they actually went all the way through, okay? And then this, you know, this is just another example of somebody, they didn't really get to the sedimentary cycle. They spent their time in that subcycle. All right. Now, the last thing real quickly is I just put this up here. So you did 20 rolls. All right. I said it was 100,000 years per roll. So that's 2 million years. And that seems like, wow, a totally long period of time. All right. And for humans, it is. But in the grand scheme of things, for the Earth is 4.5 billion years old. 2 million years is really not that long. Okay. So this rock cycle has been going for 4.5 billion years and will continue going on and on and on. To help summarize and remember the differences between observed characteristics and properties and inferred characteristics and properties, I just wanted to go over a little list here. So observed properties are different from inferred properties because inferred properties you can't actually see. So, for example, heat and pressure, I would ask you, can you see heat and pressure? The answer would be no, because we would find it really deep under the earth in a place that would be difficult and or impossible to experience. Weathering and erosion is an observed property. You can see sediment tumbling down off of the bank of a river into a river when it rains, and then the river is muddy and dark and carrying the sediment away, eroding it, you can actually see that and experience it. So if you're not sure, just ask yourself, can this process be observed? Now that we've summarized about the rock cycle and the subcycles found in the rock cycle, the sedimentary, the igneous, and the metamorphic side cycles or subcycles. I do just want to summarize also about the observed and inferred properties and characteristics. They all make up this very dynamic, constantly changing environment that's found on the surface of the Earth and below the surface of the Earth.